Welcome to Insight Hub, the video series dedicated to the world of data and brought to you by MİRACLE's data practice.
Hello everyone and welcome to Insight Hub video series. I'm Ramyashree Pichkala, working as a machine learning research associate for MİRACLE Innovation Labs. In this video, we are going to predict whether the customer will pay the loan or not. Today's agenda, we will be covering about R programming, what is R Markdown and why we are using it. Then we have an overview of application. Later we will discuss about our application benefits and how logistic regression will help to solve our problem. And later we will discuss about architecture flow followed by a live demo. Let's see about R programming. It's an open source programming language and environment for statistical computing and graphics. It is similar to S language. Coming to all programming languages, more people choose R rather than S because of its open source and it provides many functionalities in the form of packages for free. By using R, we can build shiny dashboards, flux dashboards, Word and PDF documents, notebooks. We can also integrate our R applications with Power BI and Tableau, etc. All these are done with the help of packages. So these are the various packages which we have. And here we have R Markdown to create the documents and ggplot for graphs, Shiny for creating the dashboards and Lubridate to work with the dates and Sparkly to integrate with R. Why we use R Markdown? It is a file format for making dynamic documents, PDFs, HTMLs with R. The document contains chunks of embedded R code. This will help to run the R code as a chunks. Like we can run the specific parts of code instead of running the whole file at a time. It provides quick reproducible reporting from R where we can update our documents at any time with snippet option. We convert our document into several common formats like HTML, PDF, notebooks, Word documents, slideshows and many more. We can even use render function to build a report from our file or we can use snippet button in R Studio. Also, we can easily deploy our document to the Shiny apps.io. Application overview. Nowadays, there are numerous risks related to bank loans, both for banks and borrowers who are getting the loans. The risk analysis associated to bank loans needs understanding about the risk and risk level. Banks need to analyze their customers for eligibility. The application has the customer details such as loan amount, loan duration period, interest rate, EMI and annual income, etc. By these details, we can easily monitor the customer's transaction and activities so the risk around loans can be reduced. Application benefits. This application helps bank management to understand and analyze the major factors that have influence in loan permitting for customers. The management can have a clean view on customers' loan strategy approvals by visualizing the factors which have been influencing more in sanctioning the loan to the customers. They can also visualize the overall performance of bank. That is, they can check how better they are satisfying the customer needs over period to period, so that they can take proper measures in time to avoid major risks. Logistic regression. It is one of the supervisor machine learning algorithm. Supervisor machine learning algorithm makes analysis on given set of samples. It searches for patterns with the value labels assigned to data point. Logistic regression is mainly useful for the classification tasks. This algorithm applies a logistic function to a linear combination of features to predict the outcome of a categorical dependent variable based on predictor variable. Let's suppose that we want to predict if there will be a snowfall tomorrow. Here the outcome of the prediction is not a continuous number because there will either snow or not, like either he can pass or fail, head or tail, 0 or 1. So these are all the conditions that describe the logistic regression. The probabilities that describe the outcome of a single trial are modeled as a function of explanatory variable. Logistic regression helps to estimate the probability of failing into a specific level of the categorical dependent variable based on the given predictor variable. Let's have a look at our architecture flow. The data is collected from various data sources like data lake, big data, flat files, Excel, and CSV files. From these collected data, we created documents with R Markdown, which is an extension of .rmd file, which contains the combination of Markdown and R code chunks. Generally, in R Markdown, we can use inline R code, where we can insert our R code in plain text. The .rmd file is fed to knitr, which executes all the R code chunks and creates a new document, which is .md document. It has both R code and its output. So all this process can be done in a single render function, or we can use knit to perform all this process. The Markdown document, which is generated by a knitr, is then processed by pandoc that creates a web page, PDF, Word document, or dashboards, or any other formats what we want. So whatever document we get from here is integrated with the Tableau. Let's have a quick demo on how we predict the loan default. This is the Tableau dashboard, where we turn our data into interactive analysis. We can understand patterns easily with this analysis without going into our data deeply. Coming to our dashboard, here distribution of loans by state. Here we are analyzing how much amount of loans are sanctioned according to the state wise. Let's move into our analysis. It shows the total EMI amount that was paid by the customers to the banks of each state. So here in Andhra Pradesh, almost 1 million amount is collected as a EMI by the bank. Similarly, for the state Maharashtra, 5 million amount is collected as a EMI. Number of loans by state. Here it displays the total number of customers who took loans in bank. For example, for the state Andhra Pradesh, the bank sanctioned loans for 458 customers. And with the Uttar Pradesh, the bank issued loans to 4,170 customers. We have a range for loan counts. The mean is 27, like the bank sanctioned loans to only 27 customers in that state. And max is the 4,000. So here we see that for UP, the loan count is 4 lakhs. So we can say that the maximum number of loan borrowers are in Uttar Pradesh. Total loan amount by state. Here we are showing the total amount that was took by loan customers in that state. For suppose in MP, the customers took 115 million as a loan amount. Prediction of loan amount. We have a data which tells for each year how much amount of loan is sanctioned by the bank. So here I have predicted the loan amount that was issued for the grace period of 2017 to 2018. Our prediction model says that the bank may sanction 300 million as a loan amount to their customers. Coming to our next tab. There are many reasons to take loans. So this analysis shows what are the loans that most customers desire to take. Here we have a top 5 EMI purpose of loans. The top category who pays more EMIs from or from pay of other loans. The customers pay 41 million as a EMI for in this category. Later it's go to pay credit card bills. For paying credit card bills, they paid EMI as 10 million amount. Here we are showing the home ownership of borrower. Like we are getting the information like the borrower's house details, like whether they are in rented or home own house or they have any properties. So here we see that there are almost 1.4 billion customers are there who took loans under mortgage. And the customers who are in rented houses took 1.2 billion amount. And in the customers in the own house, they took 200 million amount as a loan amount. So from this we can say that the more borrowers are from under mortgage and rental houses. Here we are analyzing the purpose of loan less than 1 million. In this we have two factors, in and out. In is the less than 1 million and out is the greater than, like the loans above 1 million. So to pay off other loans, credit card bills, home renovation, others, start business, agriculture. So these are all the categories that comes under the above 1 million loan sanction. So these like to purchase a car or for marriage and medical, to buy the house. So these are all the categories which falls under less than 1 million. So this is the graph based on loan amount issued by the bank every year. So based on our historical data, we have plotted the year-wise loan amount that was issued by the banks. In 2012, 20 lakhs amount is sanctioned as a loan amount to the loan customers by the bank. And in 2013, 114 million amount is issued as a loan amount by the bank. And in the 2014, the amount is double. They were almost sanctioned 301 million amount as a loan amount. So like this, we can observe the patterns that year-wise, the loan amount is increasing. So similarly, we can see that the growth of giving loans are increased year by year. Coming to our prediction, here we are predicting if the new customer approaches the bank for loan. So the bank management verifies all his details, and if the details falls under the criteria of bad loans, like if the fields matches with the patterns who are not paid, then the management couldn't approve the loan. So for example, if the customer took 1,98,000 as a loan amount with a duration of 22 months and he pays 7,000 as a EMI every month to the bank and his annual income is 8 lakhs. So with these details, my prediction model says that the customer with these features has 58% chances out there to pay the loan. Let's change the input loan to 3 lakhs and our duration is 31 and he pays 5,700 every month as a EMI and his annual income is 9 lakhs. So with these features, my model says that there are only 6% chances out there with these features of the customers that they are going to pay the loan. So mostly my prediction says that he is not gonna pay the loan. So by these results, the bank management decide whether they can sanction the loan to the customer or not. This is the application is all about.
Thank you for watching a video on Inside Hub, the video series brought to you by MİRACLE's Data Practice. For more videos, please visit miraclesoft.com/insidehub.